Okay. Is to get it as cold as possible with minimal dilution, right? That's normally achieved by shaking and or stirring. What we're going to do here is make the Vesper Martini, but with liquid nitrogen. So for two, this is a 3 ounce martini. We're gonna freeze all the booze that you just saw me put in, okay? So with the nitrogen, which is boiling at minus 196, okay? So it just hits, freezes, and evaporates. Now, you get all the aroma of the gin and the lemonade. There you go.
Totally. Yeah.
Good times. All right.
Yeah, we can go and see if baby button.
So we're going to make sure this is completely frozen. It is. All right. Now, we're going to have to bring this back to a drinkable state if you look in here right now. Let's see. Right, all frozen. Not very drinkable at the moment.
Oh, I should have time-lapsed it.
Get a fresh bottle of gin.
Alright, so it's an ounce and a half of gin to a full ounce of Kettle One vodka and some lemonade balm. All that is frozen, it's not drinkable right now, so we're gonna use some room temperature alcohol. And hopefully we have a martini. If I do this right, basically what will happen is a drunk rabbit is going to jump out of here drinking your martini.
Oh, that wouldn't be the first time.
A couple things you're going to notice when I pour, hopefully, if the drunk rabbit doesn't drink it, is the viscosity, and perhaps the color. Any sort of white chunk that you see, it's just frozen alcohol. See how thick it is? It's almost white, right? So that's going to become clear in just a minute. And it's the pot that keeps on giving. Possibly get a martini. One for you, the Vesper.
James Bond Vesper.
Making James Bond proud. one martini at a time.
Thank you.
There you go.
Thank you.
Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.